Welcome to Moving Forward with Uponor. I'm Daniel.
And I'm Marcus.
And we're here every Thursday to talk to you about all things Uponor, including plumbing, mechanical, and industry. So we've got a really cool topic today. We're gonna geek out on tools. We've got a little bit of a teaser here, but in order to properly introduce this thing, we brought in our good friend, Parker Kessel from Milwaukee. Parker, if you wanna jump in.
Yeah, thanks for having me here, guys.
It's been really cool to have you here to talk about this tool. So I think first, maybe let's talk about kind of just the Uponor-Milwaukee tool relationship a little bit. So Milwaukee and Uponor have been partnering since the late 2000s, right? And really what it was kind of us understanding that we're really good at making pipe and fittings, not so much tools. And we wanted to partner with somebody that made really good power tools and was gonna make our customers more productive.
Yeah, the thing that really excites us the most about the partnership that we've had for so many years is just the years of reliable connections that we've been able to deliver in between our tools and your guys' material for the end users that are using and making plumbing connections. And also just the productivity enhancements that we both have been able to make, just advancing the career field to make faster connections as well.
So originally we came out with the first M12 tool, followed that up with the M18 tool, and also the Force Logic tool, which allows us to do up to 3-inch.
That's right, and then earlier this year, Milwaukee launched the Rapid Seal heads to go with the new M12 FUEL. Parker, why don't you just briefly break down the M12 for us and some of the new benefits?
Exactly, going back to really the history of the M12 model, came back out in 2010, I believe it was. Really a reliable solution, hasn't been touched for a while, loved by many people, but we thought it was about time to update this to the FUEL model, since that's really been the advancements of the Milwaukee brand. So what we did with this, actually two innovations, you hit it on the head. One, we overhauled the tool and we overhauled the heads. Overhauling the heads really gave us a better sealing performance in those colder climates, where guys were maybe seeing times to seal taking a little longer. That's really the process improvement that we took to make that pressure test go by so much faster, right? Knowing that's the last thing you have to do to get off the job site. And then we also knew that guys are doing 1-inch connections even more, especially on those larger job sites, even residential, you're seeing those more and more common with larger houses. So from 1/2 inch or 3/8 inch, I should say, all the way to 1 inch, we sped up the expansion speed, which results in up to 35% faster connections.
And that all boils down to that better productivity for a mutual customer, the contractor, the installing contractor. So more productivity, quicker installation, quicker sealing time.
Yeah, we took we have a very productive connection method, and then the tool behind it, we wanted to match it to be just as productive.
All right, so enough of talking about the M12 FUEL. Let's take a drum roll and open up this M18 FUEL and take a look.
Yeah, exactly. This is our M18 FUEL 2-inch ProPEX expander with one key. Really excited about it. Just announced it should be coming out before the end of the year here, so you'll see it on your job sites then. So many productivity improvements that we packed into this.
Yeah, so we're really excited about this tool. Obviously, there's a lot of kind of cool things going on here. It's a little bit different than the Force Logic tool, and it's a little bit different than the existing M18 tool, right? So it's kind of like a mesh between the two of them.
Yeah, that's a great point. It really comes down to the capacity of it. The reason it shares both. It has the capacity to go from 3/8 inch all the way to 2-inch. So it has the 2-inch capacity that you're using your Force Logic PEX expander for, but also a lot of the size and speed that you're seeing on your former M18 tool.
Right, so maybe let's talk about just a little bit of the differences as to how maybe this one's kind of optimized for 2-inch, let's say, versus like the Force Logic tool.
Yeah, great question. So the Force Logic PEX expander obviously does from 2-inch all the way to 3-inch PEX, and doing the larger sizes, there's a little bit of trade-off of the capacity of the tool, but the size and speed of the tool that comes along with that. So really creating a solution that's optimized for jobs going up to 2-inch, that's the tool right here. And being able to do that and optimize that solution, we're able to make it smaller, lighter, and faster. Right. The three things that are on everyone's bucket list.
Exactly.
And kind of go along the lines too with that, I noticed on the back side, it almost looked like a size ranger, size, like a clutch. I see there was a switch for a 2-inch size, a switch for 1.5 inch and smaller. What is that? Because I think that's the first time we've seen that on a Milwaukee tool, expansion tool, and also to be new to the market.
Yeah, so it's a new feature, you're right. We've never had it on a tool before. It's our pipe size selector here. And really what it helps us do is be able to optimize the expansion speed for multiple different sizes. So we have two modes. We have a mode for 2-inch, and then we have a mode for 1.5 inch below. And what that really delivers is the fastest expansion speed. So at 2-inch, we're delivering 3 times faster connections. Really is gonna game change the time to make a connection there. But also knowing that this is gonna do 1.25 and 1.5 connections probably most often, we wanted to make that faster as well compared to the prior M18 solution. So with the flip of this switch, you can make faster connections, which we're really excited about.
So what happened? What type of design or what type of issues or concerns you had if an installer forgot to switch it? So if I'm doing a reducing T, let's say, with our ProPEX connection, and I was going from a 1/2 inch and then had to do a 2-inch and forgot to make that switch, what does the tool do? How does it react?
Right. So the expansion speed and the force is really optimized to do the sizes that we talked about. So if you would do 2-inch, you're expanding a 2-inch connection in the 1.5-inch and below speed. The reason why is that 2-inch mode is optimized for 2-inch PEX. The result would be the tool would shut down for a brief 5 seconds and then flash the work light at you. If you see that, all you have to do is flip the switch and it'll start running right away again.
That's fantastic. That's great. So even so, it's almost bulletproof. I know that's a big word to toss
protects
around.
Itself.
Protects itself, protects yep. the installer.
It was key that we were able to protect this investment, knowing that all the way from the tool crib to the job site that was used correctly and will last the lifetime of it.
That's great. So now staying kind of on, let's say we're doing a 2-inch size, we talked about the 2-inch mode of the tool. Now I see this, the 2-inch head has some markings on it or engravings that looks like it's a different type of design or different type of head specific for the M18 fuel.
Yeah, this 2-inch head is only for the M18 fuel. Really excited about this head actually for a couple of reasons, and it made a great tool because of the innovation that we packed into this head. So really you had a trade-off, especially when you're doing the larger sizes like 2-inch. Typically you'd have to make a longer tool like our former solutions over there before. What we actually did is we instituted what we call the integrated cone design in here, and that extends and kind of telescopes out of the head. If I run the tool here, you'll be able to see it come right out the end. That telescopes out, and that's kind of an extension of the tool cone. Because of that, we can shorten the full travel length of the tool cone, ultimately resulting in a much, much shorter tool, but also significantly lighter. We're seeing this tool come in with the 2-inch head on it in battery, 5 pounds lighter than its predecessor to do 2-inch. So lighter tool, more compact, knowing that the connection speed is really the pacing item for installers' days. We're excited. All you have to do is flip the switch, obviously install the right head, and you're ready to go.
So let's talk a little bit about installer ergonomics, right? So this, obviously different design, more upright versus the existing Force Logic tool. So typically what we see people doing is install, if you're overhead, right?
Yep.
You have it like this kind of lunchbox style, as we kind of refer to it. And the problem is you literally have two hands to really kind of, with the weight of it and the positioning of it. And we also see guys, kind of relying upon the head and the pipe to actually support the tool. Mm-hmm. And with that D-handle design, the ergonomics are gonna be a lot better for the person doing the installation.
Yeah, so the D-handle design, we're really excited about it. Not having to do 3-inch on this tool and being optimized for 2-inch, we're able to take a lot of weight out of that. And that really allowed us to do the D-handle design. Also, I spoke about the head being more compact. If this was a longer solution, this wouldn't work. But because we shortened it, because we made it lighter, we really have the D-handle. And to your point, having this D-handle, you can pick it up with one hand, make a connection with one hand and hold the pipe with the other. And that allows really that productivity kind of in two ways. One, you don't need that helper to come over so they can be making connections by themselves. That's two workers now in the game. But also just the fatigue throughout the day. Not having the weight in the tool, being able to do it with one hand, really keeps you in the game longer. And when we talk about longevity in your career field, this is crucial stuff. Just being able to make it through the day is just a start. We really care about the installer in the long run.
Right, we talk a lot about weight with the piping system, right? It's no different than with tools. Obviously, the lighter you can make things, the longer you're gonna last in the field and not wear out your knees and your back and all that kind of stuff.
So. Yeah.
So those are great points talking about, daily work as an installer or user using this tool, keeping the weight out. The new M18 fuel tool comes with 2 XC50 batteries. What are installers seeing in the field at a 2-inch size and a XC50 battery? How many fitting connections, joints can they make?
Yeah, I'm glad you asked this question, because every installer, the moment they see a Milwaukee solution, want to throw the biggest battery on it possible right away. But we're so excited about the XC5 though, because we left the tool out in the field for installers to use for several months, and the feedback has been very positive about this battery. Installers making multiple days worth of work just off of one battery. Remind you, we have two kitted. So really are going to be able to get a lot of connections made on this while having a smaller, lightweight battery compared to maybe if you want to throw a 12-0 on it. We're happy with XC5-0.
So talking about those smaller sizes too, I know a question we get is, what's the compatibility with the different expansion heads? So we have different kits out there. Now we have, this will be the fifth tool to this family. What type of compatibility are there in the expansion heads with this new tool?
Yeah. We have a lot of heads out there now that we have the standard heads, and then we also have the rapid seal heads. Right. So this tool is compatible with all Milwaukee expander heads from 1.5 down. And then it has its own 2-inch head. So this tool is not compatible with the Force Logic's 2-inch expander head, but is compatible with those 1.5, 1.25 heads that you had in your prior M18 kit.
Right, and you can obviously see it's very visible, the collar size on the Force Logic tool versus the new M18 FUEL tool. So hopefully, you know, if, before somebody even were to try and thread this on there, you could visually see that that's not gonna happen, right?
Yeah, and it's locked out. So you can install that on this. You don't have to worry about that happening. You also, for people that want to put the 2-inch head on our prior M18 tool, it's not gonna work as well.
Okay. Yep. Cool, so we've talked about head compatibility, battery life, tool weight, ergonomics. Anything else we want to hit on about this tool specifically that we want people to know about?
Yeah, I mean, the most important thing, right, when being a plumber or mechanical installing pipe, is you want a reliable connection. And that's something that we've been excited about in our partnership with Uponor for so many years. When we first came out, we developed an auto-rotating head mechanism that really takes kind of the reliance out of your installer pivoting the tool every time, and it's been key to the reliable connections we've made, and we put that in this tool just like every other solution that we have, and it's the backbone of what guys have come to trust from the both of us.
Right, and we've talked about in a previous video, when we talked about just the ProPEX connection method in general, the importance of head rotation and kind of why that is important to a connection integrity. So if you guys want more information on that, you can check out our ProPEX connection videos, as well as some of our other episodes of moving forward. So anything else we want to talk about today, Marcus?
No, this is all great discussion. We appreciate you joining us today, Parker. Uponor is excited to get this tool on the market. I know our users and installers are excited to get this in their hands. I can't wait to hear about that feedback firsthand. I know it's going to be a big, it's continuing to disrupt that market now going up to 2-inch side. Better productivity, quicker installation. Is all exciting.
Yeah, and we're really excited too. It's been a great partnership, and when you think about the M12 coming out earlier this year and this tool, we really are gonna have the best productivity story from 3/8 inch all the way to 2-inch when you put these two solutions together.
Yeah, it's awesome. So if somebody wants to find out more information on this tool, where can they go?
Yeah, visit the product page on milwaukeetool.com. You can just search the M18 FUEL 2-inch ProPEX Expander, or if that's if you forget that, the model number is 2932, and you'll be able to find the kits, the accessories that go with it, and everything that we talked about here today as well.
Awesome. So really exciting. I'm really glad to have you on to talk about this new tool in the Milwaukee partnership. If you guys want to find out more information about Uponor, you can check out www.uponor.com. Again, like and share this video, as well as post some comments, and we will try and answer those. And thanks again for watching.
Thank you.
Thanks, guys.